the food! I was never going to take the food! We just gave the bloody food!
It has long been customary for the people of Minas Ithil to offer an amphora of water or wine to any visitor from beyond our walls. Such travelers were rare, especially recently, and making the trek to the frontier almost guaranteed a thirsty guest. But when our need was greatest, no one from Gondor came to our gates, thirsty or otherwise.
This amphora, it is older than it appears.
Just as well we reclaimed it then. The orcs would sully it with their grog.
I do not fear the orcs, but in the deep of night, I will admit this. I fear their drums. An orc can be defeated in battle. His threat can be walled off or outmaneuvered. But the low rumbling of the drums, that cannot be halted by any artifice of man. Those drums are the heartbeat of their factories, and every beat marks the orcs' relentless advance. We seized these drums in a raid, and I locked them up in the Great Hall so that no orc could ever play them again.
So the orcs have musicians among them?
Hardly. Uruks are made for warfare, not artistry.
There is a beauty in power. There is a beauty even in violence. But there is no beauty in tyranny. In the rule of one. That is why he must be stopped. I saw a battle upon a tower. I saw the Dark Lord defeated and a Bright Lord take his place.
There are no dwarves in Mordor. At first glance, this land would seem to suit them. Plenty of stone for carving and ore veins to mine. This shield belonged to a dwarf from another age who did come to Mordor, though not as a craftsman nor a miner. Now that Minas Ithil no longer contains the orcs within Mordor, the dwarves will have to put down chisel and hammer and pick up their shields once more.
Dwarven shield, but where are the dwarves?
Deep underground, coveting their treasure, no doubt.
This statement of stewardship reads like a mundane description of lawmaking, but it is one of our most treasured documents. Gondor is a realm of law, not of kingly pronouncements. Since the disappearance of Eärnir, our last king, Gondor has thrived under the guidance of ruling stewards, each a lord of Minas Tirith. The steward's office is hereditary, and its decrees are law, unless a king someday returns to Gondor's vacant throne. And even then, I'm not sure what use we'd have for a monarch, save to keep the cushion on the throne warm.
These were the words that freed Gondor from its kings.
And yet the steward rules from a throne room, does he not? It's scarcely different.
But some things were lost forever. But some things were lost forever.
What did this device do?
Probably nothing. The Numenoreans experimented too much and perfected too little.
Slow down their machinations.
They rely too much on contraptions.
To wed. They stalk and lurk, then lash out so furious. Yet our bulwark is proof against their rage. Our hard-ringed, hand-forged armor impervious to predations from the powers of darkness, no matter how vicious or how vile. To assail the Bright Lord is to falter.